Are we ready to praise? Are we ready to worship? Oh, what a day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Psalms 95 says, oh, come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and make a joyful noise unto him with songs. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are deep places of the earth, and the strength of the hills is his also. The sea is his, he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Oh, come, let us bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God. We are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. There's a Hebrew word I want to share with you today. It's pronounced ruach. Means joyful noise. But it also means to shout. Alarm, shout with joy, to blow an alarm, to cry out. We come here to celebrate. We come here to blow an alarm, to cry out, to cry aloud, to make a joyful noise. You know why we make this joyful noise? Because we are loved. You are loved so much that God says, I'm going to send you my son Jesus to show how much I love you, to be your sacrifice, to be your savior, to show the fullness of my grace and mercy. I give you what's most precious to me. And whosoever receive this truth into their heart, there will be an outpouring of praise. There will be an emptiness, an emptying of worship. And there will be no doubt to the world that you are a child of God. So we come today to worship. We come today to worship Emmanuel, God with us. Let us put our hands together today for Jesus. Let us stand on our feet and worship God here today.
Let us adore him.
Come, let us adore him.
Let us kneel down.
Kneel down before him.
Let us worship and.
Worship and adore him.
Oh, come.
Come.
Come, let us.
Come, let us adore him.
Let us kneel down before him.
Kneel down before him.
Worship
and adore him.
Worship and
adore him.
Oh, come.
Come, let us adore him.
Let us kneel down
before him.
Let us worship and.
Emmanuel.
worship you.
We worship you.
Oh, Lord, oh,
we worship you,
Jesus. We worship, worship you, Jesus. Oh, come on.
You're faithful.
Yeah.
Joyful and triumphant. Oh, come here to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, and kneel down before him. Come, let
Amen. Amen. We worship God here on today. We praise God here on today. We worship God for who He is. We praise Him for the gifts and the mighty acts that He has done. Is anybody here a witness to the wonder-working power and the miracle of Jesus? I just thank God today for His gift that wakes me up in the morning, for His gift that tucks me in at night, for His gift that sustains me in the low places, in the high places. We serve a God that is magnificent. Let us continue to be in awe of the awesomeness of God. Bless you as our dancers come at this time.
God, our Creator, our Savior.
Savior, our life, our breath, our nourishment, our air, our all in all. We bow down before your throne of grace this morning. And we gather in your name. Too often we look to receive during this commercialized time of the year, where our focus should mainly be on the gift of love you've given us. So today, God, we say thank you. Thank you for sending us our deliverer. Thank you for sending us our teacher. Thank you for sending us your lamb. Thank you for sending us the Son of Man, our Savior, the Conqueror. Thank you for sending us the true vine, the living water. Thank you for sending us the bread of life, our Messiah. And just like the prophecy said and now being fulfilled in us, we call him Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Thank you for sending us your Son, Jesus. Jesus is what we praise. Jesus is who we come to worship. Jesus is who we have life and have it more abundantly because of. Jesus has promised to come back to receive us unto himself, to take us to glory. And Lord, we are excited about that. And Lord, just hearing that quickens our spirit. It makes us anxious even for just to see his face. Lord, we thank you today as we celebrate your mercy and our victory. Lord, we celebrate today as we celebrate your grace and our sacrifice. We celebrate your Son, who is our champion. Thank you as we celebrate your love and our Lord, Jesus the Christ. Let all hearts and minds say amen and praise God. Amen.
Come on. Amen. Jesus is the reason. You know, Christmas time is not about the presents, but it's about his presence. It's not about all the lights, for he is the light. Jesus is the reason for every season in my life. So when you receive that truth, then you can have praise at the mountaintop as well as the valley. You can have a season, a storm in your life, and he can still receive your praise. Jesus is my reason for every season. Amen. Let our dancers come at this time. God bless you.
Let every heart Yeah.
if nothing else, to show the conditioning of our dancers. Number 10, we started it over. They look like, seriously? Like, seriously, let's get it. So I thank God for their conditioning. I thank God for their ministry this morning.
The first chapter of John, the 19th verse. John 1 and 19, hear these words. Now this was John's testimony when the Jews of Jerusalem sent priests and Levites to ask him who he was. He did not fail to confess, but confessed freely, I am not the Christ. They asked him, who are you? Are you Elijah? He says, I am not. Are you the prophet? He answered, no. Finally, they said, who are you? Give us answer to take back to who sent us. What do you say about yourself? John replied in these words of Isaiah the prophet, I am the voice of the one calling in the desert. Make straight the way for the Lord. Now the Pharisees who had been sent questioned him. Why then do you baptize if you're not the Christ, nor Elijah, nor the prophet? I baptize with water, John replied, but among you stands one you do not know. He is the one who comes after me, the thongs of whose sandals I'm not worthy to tie. By this all happened at Bethany, on the other side of the Jordan where John was baptizing. The next day, John saw Jesus coming toward him and he said, look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. This is the one I meant when I said a man who comes after me has surpassed me. He was before me. I myself did not know him, but the reason I came baptizing with water that he may be revealed to Israel. The scripture says, among you stands one you do not know. Is it possible for Jesus to be present all around us and we not know him? We can come to church and sing songs of praise, even pray in his name and read the word and yet never know Jesus. We come to know only what others have learned of him and taught us, but never really got to know Jesus for ourselves. I declare that maybe, just maybe, the goal for this Christmas ought to be to know Jesus for ourselves. Maybe our goal for this Christmas is to achieve an intimacy with Jesus that will produce a volcanic shout in our spirit that Jesus is my Savior, my Lord, my all in all. Maybe we have just been in an associate kind of relationship with Jesus, but have not made ourselves completely vulnerable to him. Laid ourselves on the altar of sacrifice and says, here I am, Lord, consume the sacrifice. Let your will be done in my life. You see, church, the message of Christmas is really this. Heaven visited earth and made it possible for earth to get right with God. God became flesh and lived with us for a brief period of time so that the eyes of man could behold him. And the ears could listen to what he had to say, and the hearts of man could be transformed by him. Would it be too bold to pray a prayer at Christmas time that Jesus be revealed to us too? Lord Jesus, reveal yourself to me. I want to see you. I want to know you. I want to be transformed by you. I want to stand in awe of your awesomeness. I want to know your favor. I want to come and taste and see that you are good. I don't just want to know what others have said about you. I want to hear you speak to me. I want to feel your presence. I want to walk through the valley of the shadow of death with you. I want to praise you at the mountaintop of victory that you give me. Are you ready to receive His majesty? Are you ready to stand in His company? Are you ready to behold the King of Kings and Lord of Lords? One thing for sure is that Jesus is ready and anxious to reveal Himself to you. But the question is, do we really want to meet Him? Are we prepared to really receive Jesus like that? Are we ready to hear His words and listen to what He has to say and follow Him? Because if we are, special occasion church is not going to be good enough for us. If we are, then we're going to want to stay with Him. We're going to want to acknowledge His presence wherever we may be. We want to bathe our decisions that we make in prayer unto Him for His leadership and His guidance. We're going to want to give our life to Him because of Him we have life. And this sacrifice of my life called service to Him, it'll be a labor of love. And they say, well, why? How can you just work like that so tirelessly? It's because I met Him. And I say, Lord, not my will, but Thy will for my life. So the question is still before us. Do we really want to see Jesus? You see, because seeing Jesus means that I'm going to have to love with an unconditional love. I'm going to have to seek to work with my brothers and sisters in Christ to advance the kingdom of God. I'm going to have to understand that we're not perfect, but God has put us perfectly together, and we're here for a common goal. When I really see Him, I can't walk around with thin skin, being offended and waiting to be offended, because there is something greater at stake, and that's lost souls. Are we really ready to see Jesus? Some people have been in church all their lives and not seen Jesus because they've not saw Jesus with their hearts. We see His name written in this book called the Bible. We hear testimony of His greatness. We read accounts of His miracles, yet stand before Him as a stranger because we've not really seen Him for ourselves. You might ask, Pastor, how do you know if someone has really seen this Jesus you talk about? Well, I look to the testimony of the saints to bear witness to just a glimpse of what it means to really see Jesus. The disciples, when they really saw Jesus, they fell in a pile of smelly fish and worshiped. When Peter really saw Jesus, he tore off his clothes and jumped in the water. Paul, when he really saw Jesus, was blinded and completely transformed. He went from murderer to missionary, from persecutor to preacher, from Saul to Paul, when he really saw Jesus. You know, I read account after account of after really seeing Jesus that men were willing to and did give their life to Him. And I asked the question this morning, what might that look like for you? Well, for me, when I really saw Jesus, the tears flowed from my eyes like a river. I fell to my knees and screamed and said, thank you, Jesus, because all I had at the table of salvation was my sin. And He said to me these words, you are forgiven. I shouted, thank you, Jesus, for saving me from myself. Thank you, Jesus, for validating me, seeing that I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. Thank you, Jesus, that you have a purpose for my life. When I saw Jesus, it was time for a sacrifice, and the sacrifice was me. It was time for some work, not only in his name, but to his glory. It was time for some changes in my life. Had to do some cleaning. And I'm not just talking about cleaning of the house. I'm talking about cleaning of the life. Why? Because I knew my life no longer belonged to me. When I saw Jesus, I couldn't look at myself in the mirror the same anymore. I was changed. The who I was didn't fit anymore. And even when I tried to put on that who I was suited, didn't fit. And Jesus says, well, try this. I died for you. Suit on. And it fit. Where's this suit been all my life? When I really saw Jesus, I didn't look at other people the same anymore. I saw them with more compassion. I didn't look at them as a means to an end, or what can I use them for to get to what I really desired. Huh. I can go on, but the question still remains, are you willing to give your life to him? This is what seeing Jesus with your heart is all about. That's what beholding the Lamb of God is all about. That's what it is to receive the grace and mercy of God. That is what it's all about. This Christmas season, it is my prayer that you see Jesus like you've never seen him before. It is my prayer that you can declare him as Lord of your life, crown him as King of your lives, and spend an eternity thanking him for saving your life. As the choir sings, I pray that no matter what your walk with Jesus is today, that you see him with greater clarity than you've ever seen him before. God bless you and God keep you this morning.
Where they lay, keeping the sheep on.
Christmas, because it's about Jesus. whether I wake up to a room full of presents or just a cold floor, it's going to be a Merry Christmas because I receive that gift that keeps on long after the satisfaction of what I receive on that day is going to wear out. You know, I've received a gift that comforts me every day of the year, not just one. I've received a gift that is strength when I'm weak. It's wisdom when I'm confused. It is His presence when I feel alone. It's my hallelujah in the midst of a hurricane. I'm telling you about my gift that I've received. I've received the gift of salvation in Jesus. He is the reason for every season in my life. So I come here today and every day to say thank you, God, for your child. Thank you, God, for your child that was born to die for me.
Yeah. Let's give God some praise now.
Of Miss Linda Glass. We have Joyce. Joyce, where are you on the house? If you're in the house, let's stand. We have Natasha. We have Kristen. Let's give it up for our praise dancers. On this side over here, we have our soaring sopranos. We have Michelle, Scottiana, Sharona, Kavina, and Felicia. Come on, give it up. And over here we have our awesome altos. Sharita, Sierra, Janice, Faith, Beverly, Lucy, Akilah, Barb, Jennifer, and Eldria. Come on, let's give it up. We have our mighty, 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 mighty tenors. Come on, let's give up. In the front here, we have Mike, Tony, Reggie, Maurice, Shonda, Melody, Lauren, Lori, Kush, and Linda Glass in the back. Come on. Your voice and sing, ooh, sing, ooh, yeah. Make it so sweet, so sweet, so sweet. Now we can't complete this without the band. We have Terry on drums, Mr. Glass on sax. We have Robert Hodges on keyboards. Come on. Sing, ooh, yeah, yeah. Sing, ooh. Wait, I forgot. Myself. Veronica Portis. Married to the wonderful, one and only Pastor Cedric Portis.
Oh.
wait. I think we need to do something a little bit different. I think the guys, y'all need to hear from the guys, right? We got a different kind of version of Silent Night, and we want to do that one for y'all. Would y'all receive them today?
It was in night my mind. All through the house.
I just wanted to be free.
It was the night before Christmas.
To all our friends.
All not a creature was stirring.
Would you just
not
listen to me?
Ooh.
by the fireplace, watching the gleam of trees. If I had just one wish for this world, let's give thanks.
Holy in the world.
So
Jesus, tender and bright. Sleep in heaven. Sleep in heaven.
Told you we had something special for you today. Amen. So we could bring ourselves back. You know, as I prepared for this time, and I wondered what it would be like to imagine Christmas without Jesus. And I imagined that there would be no excitement, because there would be no hope. That would be just manufactured celebrations that wouldn't really be genuine. We try to smile to cover up our soul crying in anguish. Can you imagine Christmas without Jesus? This would mean an eternity of separation from God. This would mean that I'm really not forgiven for my sin. This means that I cannot love you. I cannot even maintain a relationship, because I don't even love myself. I can't imagine a celebration of Christmas without Jesus. As with my life, I cannot imagine my life as a celebration without Jesus. I mean, I kicked it, don't get me wrong, but it was nothing like the joy that I feel with Jesus. Because now I have a reason to celebrate. But you don't have to wonder anymore. You can open the present of salvation today by giving your life to Jesus. because there is no Christmas without you.
Thank you.